Hello. Let's plug in our hot rollers and make sure that they're plugged in for at least 10 minutes before we get started. This picture shows you the difference within each individual size of hot roller, the effect it gives to your hair. Now this, you want to pause and make sure that you find your length of hair and find the appropriate measurement of what you want to use. You can also choose to wrap your hair over or under. Pause the video to read more about this. The look I'm creating today is to basically show you the difference each roller size creates and the placement if you go over or under the effect it gives to the hair. So start with blow-dried hair. If you don't have your hair blow-dried or if it's wet, you want to make sure that you watch part one of my tutorial and complete that, then come back to this video and get started because you really do need dry blow-dried hair to get the perfect end result. Create a 3-inch section on the nape of the neck and clip up the rest of your hair. Throughout the video, you're gonna see me looking to the side, and it's because I'm watching the new Good Girls season on Netflix. It's so good. If you like this show, comment down below which season is your favorite. Grab your first hot roller, start the placement in the mid-shaft of the hair, wrap the ends around, making sure the ends are smooth, and wrap all the way up to the base of the hair. Also the root. Use the clip and you're complete. Good job. Now let's move on. We're gonna continue following the same process until we've completed the entire head. We're gonna be using 2 to 3 inch section sizes, moving all the way up to the top of the head. This all depends on your head shape and the amount of hair that you have, so choose what's best for you. Just a reminder, remember to choose rods that are best for your hair length and the effect you want to create. In my case, I am actually going to be showing you the difference that each roller size can have on my length of hair. It's for educational purposes. Okay. I know you guys are doing great so far, so keep up the good work. You're gonna find that the closer you get to the top of your head, you're gonna be able to see what you're doing clearly, and it's gonna be easier for you to complete the entire head of rollers. You really have to be consistent with wrapping the ends around the roller and keeping high tension. That way that the ends are nice and beveled when we remove all of the rollers. So remember that, don't forget. Now that we are on the top of our head, we want to make sure we roll backwards. All right, you guys, continue to use high tension and make sure that the ends are wrapped around the roller prior to rolling to the base of your hair. This is very important. I know you guys are doing wonderful. You're almost done. Okay, once you completed the entire head, make sure you keep these rollers on until they cool down. Do not take them out while they're still hot because you did this all for nothing. Make sure they're cooled down completely. They're cooled to the touch. Then you can remove them. So this is a good time to apply your makeup, read a book, watch a movie. Stay indoors until it cools down. Once it cools down, you remove them. It's easy. Look at how easy that was. And look at that curl. You basically just unclip the roller and gently remove it from your hair. You start from the bottom of your hair and work your way up, just as you did when you were placing them. Hot rollers are a good alternative than using a curling iron or a flat iron to create waves. It gives you less damage. It keeps your hair healthier. Before we run our fingers through our hair, we want to make sure we have a nice hair oil on to prevent friction. So that way we prevent frizziness from happening. So you flip your hair upside down and you start to massage the base of your hair or your roots. And this is what's going to basically mesh all the sections together and create a beautiful end result. You can also take this a step further by taking a brush or a comb, a very wide tooth comb, and you can definitely use a boar bristle brush. You can continue to accommodate your hair with your fingers if you would like to as well. That way you can create the style that you desire. It's definitely foolproof. You can change your part. You can change the way that the curls face. And you can even scrunch up the ends to give it a fuller look. In this picture, you see how the hair will look once you brush or comb it out. It will give a softer, more beachy appearance, that effortless style, that Victoria's Secret hairstyle that's very popular and the most sought after. Thank you guys so much for watching. This was so much fun. I really do appreciate all of the support that I've been receiving with all the likes and the comments. Let's continue that love because it really does help my page out. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, share my content with friends and family, and I'll see you soon.